Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received a very useful comment from my viewer. In any SMPS circuit, when the IC takes startup voltage from the startup resistor, this resistor is basically connected at positive DC rail and it provides a very controlled current so that its VCC capacitor will charge linearly and it will allow a specific time to build the voltage here so that the IC will remain silent. So it is called startup time because when the capacitor is charging, it is drawing current here. And if the same time in charging phase of this capacitor, if we turn on the next circuit, it will provide heavy load on this AC circuit, rectifier circuit and filters, so that a specific time is allocated to turn on this IC. When this IC will turn on, it will start switching to this MOSFET and it will provide pulses to this transformer. Voltage will be produced in the secondary. Same time, due to this primary, voltage will be induced in this auxiliary winding. These voltage are provided to this circuit now. Now we have two paths. First path from the startup resistor, second path from the auxiliary winding. If you see here, positive voltage through this resistor are reaching to this point. And if we check here, from the cathode, positive voltage are reaching at the same point. Two type of positive voltage are reaching at pin number 7. This is question from my viewer. When IC take voltage from startup resistor first, then IC voltage take from auxiliary winding. Where the voltage coming from startup resistor goes? Let's discuss. If we see this circuit, 56k 2 watt resistor, and it is connected here at pin number 7 VCC capacitor. The same auxiliary voltage are here. Any IC, any circuit which is using startup resistor, it is working in the same way. To understand this circuit, if I have one battery here, it is providing voltage positive, negative, and I am providing voltage to any resistor that is dropping the current, then these voltage are provided to RL and it is connected here. The current will flow in this circuit from its reference point, from high terminal to low terminal. This is current path. Now if I connect an other circuit, other battery circuit at this point, this is RL, this battery, from this path it was providing 10 milliampere, but this circuit it can provide 1 ampere. Its path will this. In electronic circuit, in electrical circuit, the current have to return its origin. It is positive terminal. It is called closed circuit. So this current will never flow here. Why? Because from here it is providing 1 ampere and it is flowing in the RL, load resistance. While our this source, it was providing just only 10 milliampere. Its current is limited, but its current will flow in this circuit. This is RL. We have one source here, positive. Ground of this source and ground of RL is connected together. So this current will flow here. Why? The reference point is same. Positive, and its ground also connected to same reference point. So current will flow here. I have transformer, anything here which is providing voltage. Its ground is connected at the same reference point. So its current will flow here. But if we see its current is going here in this loop, its current will going in this loop, and its current will go in this loop. Each voltage source will provide its current to the RL depending on its capacity. Here it can provide just only 1 milliampere. It can provide 500 milliampere. So both currents will never strike, because each current, it have its own reference point, so it have to complete its circuit from the originating point. So it have to complete its path to its origin. Either it is battery, capacitor, generator, anything. So if you see this circuit, from here, positive voltage are reaching here to the IC and this ground point. This ground point is here. So current will flow from this positive terminal to the negative terminal of this capacitor. Suppose I disconnect this ground from here, or the line is broken, this IC will never take a start. Or we can say this line is disconnected from here, any point. If it is disconnected, no current will flow here, IC will never take start. If this auxiliary winding, its ground is disconnected here, or any line is disconnected from any point, it will not allow to flow any current. Why? Because it is not completing its circuit. Now, if we see here, this ground and this ground are common. When we have common reference point, so each circuit will provide its current at the same node at this point, because reference point is same. So its current will circulate in this path, its current will circulate in this path, its current will flow in this path. Sum of all currents will come at same point here. I1, I2, I3. IT will equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. The sum of all currents will equal to total current. Same here, I1, that is from startup resistor, plus I2, that is from auxiliary winding. For example, 1 milliampere and it is 20 milliampere, it is 21 milliampere. 1 milliampere plus 21 milliampere. I1, I2. Now, another scenario. This circuit can provide 1 milliampere. This circuit can provide 500 milliampere. And our load resistance, that can drive, we can say, just only 17 milliampere voltage are present, and this source is capable to drive up to 500 milliampere, but the circuit will consume only this current. Why? Depending on the load resistance. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.